The uptown scene was crowded, though. There were soldiers on leave, checking out the legend, and workers with fat defense plant paychecks, just letting the good times roll.
Won't you bother with me? Yes, I'm an evil guest.
But one day, the fun stopped.
In 1943, the guys from 126th Street and I were in this same vacant lot. In this lot, we usually played little war games, the American against the Japanese, and somehow the dark guys were the Japanese and the light guys were the Americans. But other than playing war games, we used to play baseball. That was our biggest sport in this vacant lot. But one day, while I was pitching for the team, we heard this gunshot. And all the guys from the team dropped the equipment and climbed over the fence, and it ran up towards the Braddock Hotel. So we looked in the hotel lobby, and we didn't see anybody lying down. But what we did see was this white policeman and this black soldier having an argument. And this woman ran out of the hotel, said, "Oh, he shot my son, he shot my son." So the guys from the corner, they ran in there to see what was going on. And then they saw a cop and this soldier standing there. And a little guy named Boo Boo climbed in the window, and he discovered that the bullet wound was in the soldier's shoulder. So they chased the cop inside the elevator. And by that time, a lot of people started running into the hotel to find out what went on. So then the word got out that a white policeman had shot this black soldier. Well, that whole day, up and down the street, you saw people wandering. And finally, what had happened? The policemen, they came and rescued the other policemen out of the hotel that day. And they brought him down. And I understand that they took the soldier to Sydenham Hospital. But by that time, somebody said that the soldier was dead. They thought he had died. And I didn't know any better. But the thing that happened, my mother said, "Hey, come upstairs and get off the street because things look like they're getting ready to break out." That night, looking out the window, you couldn't see things too clear. So the only thing I can recall is all during the night, you can hear glass breaking. Gunshots, I don't know who was shooting, but that's all you heard. And people running up and down, screaming on the streets and stuff like that. Then we kept hearing, you know, people talking about, wasn't that a shame, shooting a soldier?
Seems shocked. Harlem wasn't.